In this video, we will create a simplified version of Valorant Race Blast Pack ability. We will start with an empty first-person template project. First, we need to create a new actor blueprint. Then, to the new actor, we will add a cube mesh component and set it as the root component. After that, we will change the cube mesh component collision preset to custom and set it to ignore pawn objects for collisions. Then we will add a projectile movement component and set its initial speed value to 600. After that, we will add a radial force component and set its radius value to 600 and its impulse strength value to 60,000. Then we will create a custom event for this actor for its detonation. In that event, we will fire an impulse from the radial force component and destroy the actor. After that, we will create a custom event that we will use to launch this actor from a character blueprint. For this event, we will need an input vector value to determine in what direction we want to launch this actor. We will take that input value and multiply it with our projectile movement component's initial speed, and then set it as the new velocity in the projectile movement component. And then, we will add a few second delay and then fire the detonation event. After that, we will open the character blueprint. Into it, we will add blueprints that will spawn the satchel actor. We will spawn it 50 units away from the character camera in the direction it is pointing. And we will reduce its scale so the spawn satchel won't appear as a big cube. After it spawned, we will save its value to the variable in the character blueprint. And then we will call the launch event for the satchel actor. But before we spawn it, we want to make sure we don't have another spawn satchel. If we have another spawn satchel, we will detonate it. Now we can see that we can spawn a satchel and it can launch the character. But if we are moving with the character, it looks like the satchel throw doesn't work as expected. It's happening because we are not counting in character movement in the satchel velocity. We can fix that in the satchel's blueprint by getting the instigator's velocity, which in our case would be the character's velocity, and adding that to the projectile component's velocity. Now we can see that it works as expected, and this fix also makes it easier to do multiple satchel jumps. If you don't like to pause videos to get a better look at blueprints, you can find all the blueprints on my site. You can find a link to it in the description.